music reading, lesson 5. In this lesson, we're going to move up the neck a little further with the study of a collection of pieces that involve playing into the upper mid register. Now, basically, that's the location on the neck that covers the guitar's 7th reading position area, and this means that our melodies for the lesson here are going to be performed from as low as around 6th fret of 6th string up to as high as 10th or even 12th fret on the 1st string. But, you know, what determines that, as we've discussed before, is a range of the melody. You know, it just depends on the melodic ideas being performed. That's, you know, what the idea of the section of the neck will be the determiner of how high or how low that melody goes that we're reading. So, you know, in this upper mid layout area, it gives us a wide group of mid-region tones, along with some easy access to higher tones as well, and which, you know, ends up making 7th position very useful for playing songs in the low quantity, sharp and flat keys like we're going to do here today. So let's get started by making a study of our first reading piece, which is going to be in 7th position, of course. It's composed in the key of C major. All right, let's look at exercise number 1. Here we're dealing with the 7th position on the guitar fingerboard, key of C major. First thing you're going to want to do is analyze how the layout of the key of C major is going to operate in this range. Now, in the diagram that I have on your handout here, we're tracking from the C tone at the 8th fret of the 6th string. So we're just flowing through the scale, going C and D on the 6th string. And then on the 5th string, we've got E, F, and G there. We got A and B and C on the 4th string. Then on the 3rd string, we got D, E, and F. And then on the 2nd string, we've got G and A with the B, C, and D up top on the 1st guitar string. Now, when we look at the overall essence of the position, we do have availability to a B here as well. I should mention that on the 7th fret, there's a B there. We're not going to be going that low. You know, as I will be saying several times through the work that we're going to be doing on Lesson 5 Music Reading here, we're really looking at this position that we're operating in at 7th and higher to, you know, access the higher tones that we're going to have. So when we look at the music reading assignment that we have based off of this range, which, by the way, is an associate to the pattern number 4 major scale that you can find in your advanced guitar program. So you may want to play this down a few times just to kind of refresh your memory on the full layout of your C major scale at the 7th position there. But, you know, that's the association that we're having, and really into the scale that we want to, you know, use this range in for, is we want to be able to access those higher tones. So let's start analyzing what's happening with our melody line that we have here in exercise 1. We're starting off on the 3rd string, moving through a D to an E and coming around to the root of the key center here, the C tone, and that's going to take place with the D and E on the 3rd string, 7th fret, 9th fret, and then we'll come around to the 10th fret, 4th string for the root, the C. And then after that, we're going to just go through a small arpeggio, you know, having the G and the B and the D flowing through back around to the C tone on the next measure. So it's a very simple line. Then we're going to go over next in that second measure to a G tone, and we're going to be moving through an E quickly back to the G, because we're going to have a 16th note phrase there that's going to take us quickly over to a low C in this position. So in that line on the second measure, we're going to have C, G, and then quickly with 16th notes, E, G to the C tone down below 8th fret 6th string. After that, we're going to have some fun going through an F major triad arpeggio. We're going to have F, A, C, and then F, A. That's going to be the full arpeggio there, right across from 5th string to 2nd string. Brief pause there because we have an 8th note rest. Then we're going to come around to this G tone, and then we're going to have an E and then a C. So that brings around a sound of a C major triad. So we've got F major triad, and then a C major triad. And then we're going to go back and play the F major again. And then what we're going to do next is we're going to jump over to a high B. The access that we want is going to be up here on a high 7th fret B tone. And then we're going to walk up from a C to a high D. So we're really taking full advantage of this full range of the C major up in the seventh position. Very easy access, obviously, to that high D tone at the 10th fret first string. From there, we're going to double back. We'll have a C tone going over to a G. And then we're going to have a nice sequenced line, and that'll be taking the note of A on second string to the E on third, G on second to the F on third. And then from there, we'll just wrap things up going the E tone, E, D, E, G, and then a high C. And then we'll be rolling into the root to finish things off. And the main thing, you know, once you get the notes squared away, the next thing is really to understand and analyze the rhythm of the melody as accurately as possible. You will probably have to be referencing quite a lot back to the Reading 5 Melody 1 audio track. So, you know, make sure you do your download and get your PDF printed out and, you know, get those MP3s into your computer so you can listen back and have a full understanding on how the phrasing has to operate. That's so valuable when you have that access. The idea is the same as we've been doing through the other music reading units. You know, understand the position, reference it back to the scale that would sit within that position, understand how the notes flow from the music staff into how they are laid out on the guitar fingerboard, and then begin your work of your melody. You know, probably want to start by initially, you know, watching this full video through and then listening to that MP3 for the Reading 5 Melody 1 example. So I'll leave you to get rolling along and starting the practice of exercise 1 here. And I'll catch up with you next in part 2 in the next video. That was an excerpt from the 5th lesson of my music reading course. The remainder of this course is available behind a paywall on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. But I thought you might like to see this episode's segment, so I put it here on YouTube so you can get a better idea about what this music reading course actually has to offer. If you want to subscribe to my website and gain access to this program along with other courses I have, like my full complete curriculum of introductory, intermediate, and advanced guitar program, plus many other guitar courses that are available on the website, just head on over to creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up with a free membership to get yourself started. Then you can always upgrade to either a monthly or you could go for the discounted yearly membership plan. You have some choices there. You can make some options and decide what you want to do when you get to the site. Just click on the link in the YouTube description box under where it says become a member today. Smooth jazz chords introduces chord types that offer a very different sound from the chords that are used in almost every other style of music. The Smooth Jazz Chords video lesson is a two-part course that demonstrates chord types that are used in the smooth jazz style. These chords are often referred to as triad over bass note chords, and the lesson demonstrates these chord shapes as well as their use using both diagrams and example progressions. Smooth Jazz Chords is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com for the rest of this reading lesson. We'll carry on learning about the seventh position keys of D major, F major, as well as the key of G major. Also, if you have a paid membership, you'll get access to this lesson's handout, all the MP3 play-along tracks, plus a whole lot more.